Hello everyone, welcome back to ATP Creative Corner. In today's video, I am making this coin purse with lobster clasp. This coin purse is big enough to hold money, coins and even your mask. This can be used as a keychain charm or can be used as a zipper pull in your handbag. I have made this for a shoulder bag. Before we begin, please hit that subscribe button if you aren't subscribed already. Now let's get started. For the coin purse, I've taken two pieces of main fabric, two pieces of interfacing, I've taken duck canvas, and two pieces of lining of same dimensions, 6 inches across 5 inches. First, I'm going to take one of the interfaces, I'm going to fold it in half like this, and I'm going to make a curved shape at the corner like this. Now I'll cut along this curved line. I'm going to use this interfacing piece to cut all the other pieces in this shape. Now all the other pieces are ready with this shape. Next, on the wrong side of the main fabric, I'm going to place the interfacing piece like this and give straight stitches on the edges. Once done, it'll look something like this. Next, on one of these pieces, I'm going to mark points 1 inch from the top like this. I'll draw a straight line along these points. Now I'll cut along this line. Next, I'm going to repeat the same on one of the lining pieces. Next, I'm going to take a zipper of length 5 inches. Next, I'm going to place the zipper with its right sides facing downwards like this, and the lining piece with its right sides facing downwards like this. I'm using sewing clips to keep them in place. I'll give a straight stitch here. Now it's done. Next, on the main fabric below the zipper, I'm going to give a top stitch. Top stitch is done. Next, I'm going to place the top part upside down like this, and I'm going to place the zipper with its right sides facing downwards and the lining piece with its right sides facing downwards like this. I'm using sewing clips to keep them in place. I'll give a straight stitch here. Now it's done. Next, I'll give a top stitch here. Top stitch is done. Now I'm going to join the main fabric and the lining fabric together by giving straight stitches on all four sides. Once done, it'll look something like this. For the handle, I've taken an interfacing piece of 1 inch wide and 2.5 inches in length, and a fabric piece which is 2 inches wide and 2.5 inches in length. Next, I'm going to place the interfacing piece on the fabric piece like this, and I'll fold these two sides 1/2 inches inwards like this. I'll fold the entire piece in half like this. Now I'll give straight stitches on both the sides. Once done, it'll look something like this. Now I'll insert the handle into the lobster clasp like this. Next, I'm going to fold the front piece in half like this to mark the center point, and I'm going to place the handle on this point at the top like this. I'll give a stitch here. Now it's done. And our front panel is ready now. Next, to prepare the back panel, on the wrong side of the main fabric, I am going to place the lining piece with its right sides facing upwards like this. And I'll give stitches on all four sides. And our back panel is ready now. Next, I'm going to place both the panels with their right sides facing each other like this. I'll give a straight stitch here. Now it's done. Now to seal this raw edges, I'm going to give a straight stitch with 1/2 inch seam allowance. Once done, it'll look something like this. You can see no raw edges here. Next, I'll give a stitch on rest of the sides. Now it's done. Now both the panels are joined together with no raw edges on the inside. Now to seal the raw edges on the outside, I'm going to use bias binding, for which I've taken a fabric strip of 4 cm wide. At the beginning of the strip, I'm going to fold 1/2 inches of the fabric like this. And I'll place it along the raw edges like this. Now I'll cut the strip 1/2 inch more than required and fold the strip like this. I'll do the same thing on the other side as well. Now I'll give a stitch here. Now it's done. Now I'll turn the strip towards the back side of the purse like this. Now I'm going to make 1/4 inch folds twice like this. I'm going to use sewing clips to keep it in place. Now I'll give a top stitch on edges of the strip. And our coin purse is ready now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.